Great halls over there. It's a trap! Yeah, it's new, but it's not new. Effective against shields, barriers, and synthetics. Blop. At least they walk around really slowly. Cool. Oh, there's... Is that another one or is that Samara? Oh, it's a cannibal over there. Oh, there's multiple cannibals. Try this new mine out. There's more. Yep. Oh, view. View. I thought that was a view thingy. Yep, just one for now. Hello? Oh, is that one of her daughters? Oh, cool.
Mother, you came.
As soon as I was able. Shepherd, this is Falaire, my youngest. She and her sister Rila are Ardak-Yakshi. They have
Mother, they have Rila.
What?
I saw some of those creatures take her into the Great Hall. I've been trying to get there.
What are the Reapers doing here?
She's gonna lose one of them, isn't she?
Harvesting us. They're turning us into those monsters. Please, you can't let that happen to Rila.
The Ardak-Yakshi are innocent? I guess I mean, relatively speaking.
The Asari thought the Ardak-Yakshi were to blame for the attack.
This is our home. Most of us are grateful to be here. The monastery is a place Ardak-Yakshi can achieve peace.
Valaire speaks truthfully, Shepherd. I vouch for her words, with pride.
Aww. A little smile. Tiny bit, but I could see it. With that close-up helps. I believe you.
Then we have to find Rila fast. The Great Hall has a bomb in it.
Blurry.
A bomb? But didn't you come to rescue people?
Well, yes, but...
We'll try, but we can't leave this place standing, Falaire.
You sound like the commandos. They didn't stop to help anyone.
Falaire?
I'm sorry.
We're gonna try to stop the bomb.
Falaire!
Well, I hope something happens to her.
She's looking for Rila.
Hey, I want to do that.
I'll meet you there.
Please be swift.
Be swift. I have to take the stairs, I'm sorry. I have to take the stairs. How lame. I want to float downward like a true enigma. Damaged elevator.
You'd need a crowbar to pry those doors open. This place was beautiful before the Reapers came.
We'll find another way. We can't float down. I'm gonna take that way, obviously, but let's see if there's anything down here. Computer.
This is Galay. I've blocked extranet access. We don't need the students panicking about these Reaper rumors. Still, it will not hurt to tally our supplies. Please bring me an inventory before evening prayer. I'll contact Thessia later tonight to inquire what set the Asari to war. Go in peace.
She talks very quickly. Alright. Did that work? Cutscene? No. Saving, I mean? Nope. Oh, there's things. A marauder. Put those shields down. Oh, yes, there's more. Right here. Cool. That what you guys like to see? That was pretty awesome, huh? So I'm supposed to go... run around there, or what's in here? I'll grab that, why not? I have 8 medical things now. Disciple? Oh. It is a shotgun, which I will not use, but I'll take a look at it. Originally handcrafted for the exclusive use of Justicars, the Disciple shotgun schematics were finally released to Asari commandos after centuries of negotiation. The Disciple uses shells packed with micro-scale submunitions to deal staggering amounts of damage. Even shielded enemies are shunned. What? Even shielded enemies are stunned by the force of a blast from this weapon. Ceres Council shoulder guard. Okay. Oh, there's another entrance in here. Alright, so we came from there, correct? We go down. We look around, though, first. What's in here? Well, safe. 5,000 credits. Computer. Jethra, I looked over this year's candidates for supervised visits to Thessia. I'm approving everyone but Yanis. She's impulsive, cunning, and worst of all, a romantic. Find me a worse combination to let outside our walls. I find it suspicious she was even nominated. Let's look into that and pray it's not Yanis manipulating another infatuation. It takes a great deal of time and effort to persuade Thessia's government to let our best students visit their own homeworld. Unless Yanis matures, she won't be among them. Matriarch Galay. Jethra, I had the new girl put in a holding chamber. The Justicar who brought her to us, Justicar Fora, said she had trouble convincing the prisoner coming to the monastery was necessary. This may explain why the girl lashed out at her guards. She's lucky Fora wasn't here for that. The Justicar's code would have demanded an execution. I'll question some other Justicars on the level of coercion Fora's permitted to use by the code. This isn't the first time her captors arrived here terrified out of their wits, but it will certainly be their last. Metrocle again. Weapon bench? No thanks. Last chance, weapon bench. Oh, yep, barriers. Music change. Sorry, guys, I don't like being near those things. And unfortunately, I'm kind of near those things. Cool. It's dead, right? Am I hearing... Oh, that's a cannibal. Cannibal over there. Whee! I'm coming! I hear something else. Oh crap. Oh, hello. Cool. Oh, how many of these things are there? Cool. Is that it? I think that's it. Alright. All I see around here are rounds. Get it? Round here are rounds. And I'm flipping around. And I'm messing around. Water. Is that the bomb? What is that? Assault rifle precision scope. Number 2. I know something's coming. That might be the bumsty bum. Oh, a sorry corpse. Oh, here.
Another dead commando. Was she holding off Reapers or was she left behind?
Commando's workers team. She would have volunteered to guard this point.
Hope she took some down before she died.
Me too. Okay, they're misdirecting us because there's all this cover and nothing attacked us. Oh, another elevator. This one works. Excuse me, Garrus. A little pushy. Literally. I got experience just for going in the elevator. It's a bomb. Something's gonna attack us. There's a med thing here, isn't there? Medical station.
There's our bomb.
And Falaire.
She's like comatose.
Rila? Rila, can you hear me?
You're about to lose one of your daughters. Oh god. Yeah. Oh no.
Why did she do that?
Because they've begun to turn her into one of the Reaper's creatures.
You know, just pushing her on the floor didn't kill her.
Can we set up that bomb?
Not without a detonator.
Commandos would have had one. We gotta find it.
Yep. Coming.
Later.
Defense bomb? How do I do that exactly? Well, these are just husks. Do I have to be right near the bomb? Are they going to destroy the bomb? Oh, oh crap. Oh! Wait, no! I'm stuck in a animation. I did click the... Wait, I clicked it! I clicked that! Huh! Oh, nice. Oh, my. Okay, there's one there. Not so close to me, man. I don't like that. Medkit. It hits me through that, obviously. Alright, I need to find cup. Jesus, man. Oh, hello. Can I actually use this power? F? Oh my. Aim that way. Run. Run. Click it. I can't run, I can't move, I can't charge, why not? Ah! I need to get away from this. Why can't I charge when I want to? I can't even take cover here, this is not cover. Cover. I can't charge if I'm not at a target, I guess. Oh, they're all over. I can't pop out of cover. Die, damn you. Yay!
Now, let's get back to that bomb.
Shut up. Three at once, damn.
Flair, go! Take the elevator!
You alright?
Rila, what are you doing?
She's staying with the bomb.
It's too late for me. There are hundreds coming. Just go.
The detonator.
Move!
No! Rila! I love you. Rila!
Aww. We gotta move faster. I hear those things. Yeah, can we blow these up? I don't want to fight them all. They are so nasty. We gotta go. Press it. Oh.
I'm not your slave.
Way to go, you tell him. That didn't blow up the whole facility, just the Great Hall, right? Because we're fine, and we were still in the elevator going up. I'm so sorry, Samara.
There wasn't even time to say goodbye.
Few can break the Reaper's hold. Rila's will was extraordinary, as was her love for you.
We left her to die.
It was her choice.
Rila made her choice, and it has reminded me of what is truly important. Why I swore I'd lay down my life.
What is that?
Valer, the code demands an Ardak-Yakshi cannot live outside a monastery that no longer exists.
No.
What are you doing?
I'm sorry, Shepard. By the Justicar's code, there is only one way to save Valer.
No, interrupt.
Oh, no.
Paragon. Oh, you're gonna shoot yourself? No, no. Hell no.
Let go.
Never.
What are you doing?
Fulfilling the code. By throwing your life away? I won't kill my last daughter.
You don't kill yourself either.
You don't have to. Valer?
Start a new monastery.
I'll stay here. Home. No matter what's become of it. Without a proper monastery, I could have left any time. I don't need a building to honor my own code. And if the Reapers return, they won't take me alive. I promise. Then, the code permits you to stay, as you are. Once this war is over, and if I am able, I will visit, as a Justicar should.
Could use her help with the Reapers, but you could stay here with your daughter, Samara.
I'd understand if you wanted to help Valer rebuild a home here.
It must wait now that I can help oppose the Reapers. I'll speak with Valer. Then join your forces. If you'll have me, of course.
Of course.
I'd be honored.
The honor is mine, my friend.
She's awesome. Needs a bit more emotion, but she's awesome.
Everything's taken care of down here. Bring in the shuttle.
Right, Commander. I'll just follow the smoke.
Commander, I'm pleased to hear the Ardak-Yakshi situation has been put to rest.
Should I guess you're our contact inside Asari High Command, Counselor?
I'm merely here to convey the gratitude of the Asari people for concluding a difficult, sensitive mission. The next team of commandos we were sending to the monastery are now en route to Admiral Hackett instead. Farewell, Commander.
Okay. Now I'm guessing this is going to be a little longer episode because I want to check everything here. Crew update and stuff. I'm not sure I'm going to split it up because I know I want to go back to the Citadel to do the special 100th episode, hour long, so these two episodes might be longer. They're already longer. So we have Asari Commandos. They train from an early age to control their minds and bodies, seeking the ultimate economy of thought and movement. They are taught that each shot and each decision be made without hesitation. While exact training methods vary among teams, all commandos are consummate professionals. Their ambushes, quick strikes, and clever tactics have bested larger, well-armed units in thousands of recorded conflicts. Samara. The Justicars are an ancient Asari order dedicated to finding and punishing those who would harm others. They rigidly adhere to the Justicar Code, a comprehensive, complicated list of laws. By assaulting the innocent... What? Oh, okay. I thought they were still talking about what Justicars do. By assaulting the innocent, slaughtering the helpless, and refusing to acknowledge any authority above themselves, the Reapers are an affront to nearly everything the Code stands for. Yes. The Justicar Samara has set aside all other responsibilities, pledging to stop the Reapers, even if it kills her. Well, let's hope it doesn't come to that. Okay. So we found a few question mark thingies. Check in with Trainer and Edie Joker. And then move our way down to the other decks. These guys don't have anything to say. They didn't even say anything to me, like Commander.
There's a new message at your private terminal.
Thank you.
The Crucible Project received some new tech from the Asari government.
I'm glad they've decided to help the war effort.
Everybody has to fight now, no matter how pretty you are.
Hmm.
I learned that the hard way. Commander?
Alright, email. Well, a bunch. Crucible update from Bryn Cole. Dear Commander Shepard, Thank you again for all you did to get our group out of that facility on Jellix. Admiral Hackett is an amazing man, and it's a privilege to work under him. The construction of the Crucible is presenting its challenges, but my team and I are determined to crack its mysteries. Although I never rely on luck, in this instance I fear we may need a little. Stay safe, Commander. I hope our paths cross again. Sincerely, Dr. Bryn Cole. Yes, Jacob's girlfriend, I guess. Citadel meetup. From Jacob Taylor. Hey, Shepard. This Crucible project is intense. Bryn and the others are on it around the clock. Pretty soon I'll have to make a run to the Citadel to pick up some equipment at the hospital. If you've got time, want to meet me there? Things were so crazy on Jellix, it'd be great to see you in a quieter place, you know? Hope to see you around, Jacob. Headed for the front lines from Samara. Shepard, I've finished my business on Lessus. I would offer to travel once again with you on the Normandy, but the code dictates I join the fight where it is most dire. While you do your essential work, I will do my best to help hold the front. Before I depart, I'll return to the Citadel for a short time to prepare. If it does not interfere with your duties, come find me there, Samara. You mean she's not going to be on here on the ship with us? Asari squad ready. From Corrine Lemays. Commander Shepard, as of an hour ago, Asari High Command has assigned my squad to support you. We will ride with the Second Fleet until it's time to deploy. If you'll allow me a personal note, I knew a few of the commandos who went down to that monastery. Nothing will bring them back, but hearing that the place went up in smoke is the only good news I've heard in weeks. Ready to serve, Captain Corrine Lemays. You know, I don't think it got damaged that much. I mean, what's her name? Samara's daughter's still going to live there. We were able to, you know, safely finish going up the elevator, even though the bomb blew up in the middle of it. It's not as blowed up as people might think. But hey, you know, whatever makes them feel good, sleep better at night. Fine by me. Joker!
Glad you talked Samara down.
I thought I'd see her flinch from her duty.
I don't know. On one hand, that code's all she's had to live by for, God, centuries. And the galaxy goes to hell, the old rules don't cut it anymore. I mean, we're cutting some corners, right?
A few.
Well, the Alliance can always court-martial us after we save the galaxy.
Well, Samara does not cut corners.
Commander?
What are you doing, Edie?
Monitoring reports of proton storms and other space weather. With the Reapers attacking the comm buoy systems, critical warnings may be lost.
How bad are these storms?
If we are warned, not bad. If we are not warned, very bad.
Uh-huh. Thanks for the info, Edie.
Hello, Shepard.
Okay, down to other decks. Sometimes I forget which doors you can just run through and which you have to manually, you know, open.
I always love the M35 Mako. It's got heart, you know?
Mako?
Oh, come on! The M44 Hammerhead is vastly superior.
Come on, that thing's made of tissue paper. At least the Mako can take a few hits.
I'd hope so. That thing handles like a drunk rhino. No agility whatsoever.
Tell me about it.
Like a bull that can climb and climb for days.
It only climbs because of its stupid, vertically aligned mass effect fields. Jump or stick. No speed, no lateral movement.
Hey, with a cannon like that, who needs to move?
If you want that, why don't you just stick with the old M29 Grizzly?
Hey, I love that tank.
You would be one to love grizzly bears, Mr. Vega.
What? What's so funny?
He just poke a gay joke at him. Now that's so funny, though. Talking about the Hammerhead versus the Mako. That thing was a mess, but that's actually a good in-game explanation for why it handles the way it does, because of its mass effect fields. It's almost impossible to tip that thing over. You can do it. I haven't. I heard that if you tip the thing over, it can explode. But that's why it handles so weird. It's because it's constantly trying to keep itself right. You know, upright.
The next time you blow up a monastery, let me know you've left the premises, okay? I worry about you.
Yeah, well, I'm a badass.
Everything okay, Shepard?
Yep. I found some new kind of shoulders. I'm not sure which one it was. Oh, those are the shoulders. I don't know. I think I switched armors. I think I was using my old armor for a while. It's okay.
Hey.
Alright, head to engineering section. Yeah, Miss Javik. You have to stand here like him. I am Javik. All races are bullshit. He's got to be on another deck somewhere.
Power grid is in the green.
Commander?
Making a nuisance out of himself.
Nothing to report, Commander.
Crew deck. Javik in the lounge with Garrus. I'm going to save that. I'm going to save that for a little bit. See what Ashley's doing.
Hey, Commander. I dug out some letters my youngest sister wrote when she was in high school. She was having a hard time. Teen drama and all that. Just needed her big sis. I guess with everything that happened down there, I just wanted to read them again. You sure make some unusual friends, Shepard.
Just a bit.
That is not a side of the Asari I ever want to see.
That's part of why I didn't bring you down there with me.
Shepard?
Ashley? Chakwas isn't going to say anything. She's still waiting for me to finish that quest. Yeah. Let's see what they're up to. This is bound to be interesting.
Everybody was fighting the Rachni, trying to push them back through the relay. Finally, the Krogan were turned loose and stopped them.
I see.
But when the Krogan rebelled, we had to deploy the Genophage to stop them. Wasn't the only rebellion. 1,000 years later, the Geth revolted against the Quarians. That was a whole other war. Then along came the humans. My own people tangled with them for a while, and now, to top it all off, we've got the Reapers.
Here it comes.
The Ouroboros fought the Densorin. The Andoromai conquered the Vandomar, and the Jatil turned against the Jar.
So, I guess nobody really ever gets their act together.
The Sinriel claim to have found the path to eternal peace.
What happened?
The Dittaker preferred war. Wiped them out.
Huh.
I hope you guys had alcohol.
What? No disdain for other races?
Some of the crew seem shocked by the monstrosities we have encountered. They haven't seen what the Reapers could corrupt after 100 years. That was our war. Every battle conjured a new nightmare.
Mm-hmm.
This human holds such childish views of war. Your species has much to learn.
Which human? This guy here? I don't even know who that is.
Commander.
Who are you?
Samar is the kind of soldier we need in this war. Nothing gets in her way. I just hope I'm not in her way someday. That woman means business.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's a mutated Asari. The Reapers are just a giant nightmare factory that never ends. I can only imagine what the Reapers are doing to the Drell. Or the Hanar. Or the Vorcha. This could get a lot worse before it gets better.
God, Vorcha, scary enough as it is.
How's it going? How's it going?
Hey, how's it going?
It's all a brilliant tactic, when you think about it.
But it's evil.
When has that ever mattered in war?
Yeah, but converting other life forms into Reapers? I can't wrap my head around that.
Makes sense to me. It ensures you never run out of cannon fodder. Eliminates any local resistance. And for every soldier you add, your enemy loses two. The one you converted, and his buddy on the other side who can't pull the trigger on a friend.
You sound like you admire them.
Same way I admire a virus or a thresher maw. They've adapted perfectly to their situation.
But the Reapers want to destroy us.
And I have no intention of letting them. But if you don't respect your enemy's capabilities, you're in for one nasty surprise after another.
Huh. True that. Anything else? Should I run back again and check to see what else they're saying? Liara!
Excellent find, Commander. The information network terminal has been updated.
Liara's bound to have something to say about this, the Banshees.
Poor Rila. But I'm glad she set off that bomb, Shepard.
You're not upset the monastery was destroyed?
No. Not after what I saw. I don't care that they were Ardak-Yakshi. To be turned into such creatures, nobody deserves that.
Yep. And they didn't have a choice of being Ardak-Yakshi either, so it's doubly bad.
Ready for the next mission?
Suppose.
Ready for the next mission.
Alright. Correspondence from Classified Alliance Project Staff. Dr. Locke. I was working on that problem you sent me last night, and I think I found a solution for synchronizing the Crucible's energy bursts. Punch the attached capacitor redesign into your projections. It should save 3.6 milliseconds off the Mass Effect field's activation time. You can see where that leads. If you approve, I'll send the schematics to manufacturing. We'd need roughly 250,000 by tomorrow morning for testing. Dr. Cole. Dr. Bryn Cole. Intact Reaper weapon. The barrel of this Reaper weapon can be dismantled for further study. If the miniaturized energy cells powering the gun's systems are taken apart, it could lead to improvements in the damage a weapon can deal. However, an examination of its heat venting systems could instead provide the means to maximize thermal clip storage. It's kind of underwhelming. To just increase thermal clip storage. That's it? Plus 5% damage? It was 5% damage, I say. Why does it move? Stop. Galay's electronic signature. Matriarch Galay was an Asari of some importance, with connections to the Asari High Command and the Council itself. Her electronic signature can be used once before security protocols realize it has been activated by someone else. Galay's contacts can open elite training facilities for reconditioning soldiers, or, on behalf of the Asari Embassy, grant someone a discount at all Citadel stores. Oh, power damage bonus or store discount? Power damage. We have plenty of credits. Oop. So you have plus 5% for, like, all this crap. Let me just go back into it, make sure that wasn't the old values. Yeah. Okay. Got stuff. Now let me see if they say anything else.
Commander.
How's it going?
Nope. More idle chit-chat. Javik is actually functioning socially now. I was ready for scathing remarks on other races. I mean, he did put down that one crew member, but it was just one person. That entire race. Okay, so next episode, guys, would be an extra long episode, even longer than this episode, probably. So, yeah, I guess countdown to episode 100. So, I'm pretty sure we're heading back to the Citadel next episode, and all kinds of fun and hijinks will be had there. We're going to meet up with, like, everybody. It's going to be fun. So thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.